Right, hello people. So let's have another go at the survival puzzle rush. So for those who haven't seen the survival mode on Puzzle Rush before, instead of trying to do as many as you can in 3 minutes or 5 minutes, this time you get three lives. And so the idea is still to do as many as you can. But if you get three wrong, you are out. And the first time I did this, I got to 37. Let's have a quick look at the leaderboard. So oh yeah, but that's yeah, okay. That's probably not legit. Well, I'm going to tell you that 241 is almost certainly not legitimate. So yeah, that's ridiculous. He's clearly using a computer. I would think because the top GMs like Hikaru and whatever never get past sort of 80-ish. So clearly that's silly. But the rest of them, all these red labels are telling you they're titled players. So very, very good. National Masters, FIDE Masters, all master players. And they're all up in the 54s, so I'm not going to get that high. But we'll see how high we can get. Okay, how you can get on that leaderboard. Certainly won't be getting to that one. That's just silly. Okay, so play. Start. Let's see where we go. So remember, there's no time limit on this at all. So this is a nice, easy one. They get harder as you go through. Quite simply, rook takes rook is checkmate because the three pawns block the king. So that's okay. Okay, so this one, my guess is that we've got knight takes pawn check. The king will get out the way, and then we play knight takes rook. We'll have a quick look to make sure there's nothing that looks better. I don't think there is, so I'm guessing there. Oh, we put the king the other way, but it makes no difference. Knight takes rook. Okay, so far so good. Well, this is the same as the other one. We've got the three pawns blocking the king. And so the move is going to be rook here because it's checkmate along the back rank. So they start off very, very straightforward. Okay, this one's a similar pattern. Still got the three pawns keeping the king hidden. This time we'll play the rook here. This has got to go back to block, and then rook takes rook will be checkmate. So that's there and take. Okay, well, fine. Well, this one's a fairly easy one. We've got the queen and the bishop both pointing at the knight. There's nothing protecting the knight except the king. But after we play queen takes, we'll be winning because the king can't take, because the bishop takes king would be winning. It'd be an illegal move. So that's checkmate. Good. Okay, so this is going to be the back rank pattern again. We're going to force the king to the corner so he's hidden by these two pawns. So we'll start with queen takes pawn, which is check, and king takes queen will be no good because the rook is also defending that square. So we'll do that. And now we play queen here. There's no escape for the king. The only move will be rook takes, but now this rook will capture up here and that will be the checkmate. So queen to here and rook takes his mate. So an easy start. And we've got another one with this same pattern. Clearly, Puzzle Rush today has decided that back rank mate is the way forward. So a lot of the time in chess, you'll find that it's not a bad idea to just nudge a pawn forward a square in front of the king, just so you get an escape room. And there is a downside to doing that as well, because a pawn marching up the board, it's called a hook. It might be a way you can open the king up. But in this sort of position, it's a pretty good idea to have an escape square. But anyway, we can put the rook here, and now the rook has to get in the way. We take it, the bishop has to get in the way. We take it, and there'll be no other escapes. Okay, so this time there's no obvious checkmate. So the usual way to solve these puzzles is to look for checks, look for captures, look for threats. So the only two, well, I've got some, one of them is a check, as it turns out, but let's have a look. So check there, no good, because that square is not protected. So we just lose our rook. Check here, no good, because bishop takes rook. Another check is with the knight, and that's okay. Actually, that's not the worst move ever. But the king has lots and lots of escapes, not there, lots of escape squares. Knight check, if the king went here, rook there, rook. Yeah, so that's not going to be it. And now there's one more move that's check. And there, although the king can escape, the knight is also attacking this rook. So it's going to be a knight fork and we win the rook. At least I think that's going to be right. Sure enough. And just to point out, the king can't take the rook because the pawn defends. So knight takes rook. Well, so far, so good. Now this one, watching to see that the rook is guarding these squares. So if we can force the king back, we'll be winning here. And the pawn guards this one. So remember, we look checks, then captures, then attacking moves, threatening moves. So if we go check, the king has to go back. And now that's going to be checkmate because it'll be attacking the king. The pawn is defending his mate, so the king can't take. And these squares are guarded by the rook. So g6 is mate. Okay, so the knight protects the bishop. The bishop is guarding this square. The pawn is guarding these two squares. So this king looks to be in some trouble. How can we attack the king? How can we give check? Well, knight there is a check, but then the bishop's not protected, so that's no good. Knight here's a check, and then the bishop's not protected, so that's no good. And pawn takes knight. So there's only one other way to attack the king, and it's bishop here to do it along this diagonal. And then I think the only move to defend the game is this, and then bishop takes queen. So I think bishop here is winning. And that's now checkmate, because when the bishop takes, pawn's defending that square and the king has nowhere it can go. You might be able to faintly hear a crackling sound in the background. That's my sausages that I'm having for dinner. So in a few minutes' time, I'm going to have to just nip over and make sure they're not burning. It won't take 2 seconds. Right, now, I think this is probably a blunder. Well, it is a blunder because it's a puzzle. So we look at checks and captures. Now, there's a check with the bishop, but the king just sort of runs away. I've noticed that the knight is guarding this square and the bishop's guarding this one. So maybe we can bring the queen in to this square to give check. The king can't capture because the bishop's defending. So if the queen comes here, the king can't go here because of the queen, can't go here because of the queen, can't go here because of the knight, has to go back. And then I think queen, oh, maybe that's not quite going to do it. Queen here. Yeah, so then queen here will force the bishop here and queen here will be checkmate. Right, I think that's going to be right. Let's try that. I think this forces the bishop to go in front of the king. And this move to here, because the knight's defending that square and the bishop's defending this one, should be checkmate. Okay. So that pawn move has opened up this onto our queen. So we've got to do something. My instinct is queen takes pawn because that would threaten the rook and the knight. And I don't see any way to save both of them. Well, you can. Rook here will be defending and I can't play queen takes because bishop takes. But this bishop can also attack the knight. So I think that's the move. That's as predicted. And now bishop takes, because if rook takes bishop, queen takes. We've got two pieces attacking the knight, only one defender. So bishop here must be correct. Oh, well, rook takes and the queen takes rook. Fine. So winning material. Okay, this one, look at this deadly rook pointing this way. Is anything else pointing that way? Yes, it is. So it's going to be queen takes. And if you remember the puzzle a little while ago, we had the same pattern. The king is blocked in by its own pieces. Now, we can't play queen takes rook because it's defended. But if we go here, rook takes is forced. And then rook goes a bit further than that and is winning. So check and checkmate. So this is how it always works on the puzzle rushes, that the first X number of puzzles are relatively easy and then it gets harder. And I've just feeling as though this might be slightly, no, actually it's not, but it's a little bit harder. So the pattern here to look for is the queen attacking the king, but I have to choose. So I'm going to move this rook and then it will be check. You've got to put it on the right square. For example, if I go rook here, well, whoopee-doo, it's check, but rook takes queen. But if I put the rook here, it's check from the rook and check from the queen. So rook takes queen isn't going to be good enough. So we're going to put the rook here. That's now the only move, because the king was in check twice, the only thing it could do was move away. And now, of course, there's no escape square, so we put the queen in the corner. Okay, so this one we're going to set up the same pattern as we have before, which is make the king go here and then use the fact that those three pawns are trapping him. And remember the queen, don't pick that up. Nearly messed it up by mistake then. Remember the battery of these pieces, as it's called when there's two pieces working together. So queen checks, and now queen here forces the rook to take, and then our rook finishes the game. So same thing as we've seen a few times. Okay, that's 15. I'm just going to hit pause recording while I go and turn over my sausages. I will be back. Right, I'm back. Sausages have been turned over. Trying to avoid poisoning myself by overcooking the outsides and forgetting to cook the middle like classic barbecue style. But as these are in the frying pan, I should be able to avoid that. Now, white to move. I think there's absolutely no way that black can stop us just promoting this pawn. I think this is just going to be here. So here, just to do the counting, just to show you, king across, pawn up, king across, pawn up, king across, pawn up. And even if this bishop wasn't on the board, king across and the pawn gets there first. So this is the correct move and there's nothing that can be done. Oh, the king is almost doing exactly what I said. But okay, that was an easy one. Now we're playing white again. When we're going up the board. So that's check and it's threatening my queen, which means we have to play queen takes. Yeah, okay, so this is queen takes because we have to. We do. Imagine if I play king here, we just lose our queen, so that's no good. So queen takes is good. The king will threaten our pawn. And now what we do is move the pawn here. And I rather thought the black king, oh no, it won't go there because that would be cheating, would go here, but it makes no difference because we just take the pawn. Actually, do I go there? Is that better? No, it's fine. It's fine to do this. So king here, king moves up, king goes back, and then we can march the pawn. So I'm just checking because I don't want to make a stupid mistake and waste a life. See, and now the king was protecting. So, okay. Now this queen looks trapped. She can't go here or here because of the rook. The bishop is protected by the queen. The pawn is protected by the knight. The knight is protected by the rook and the queen. This square is protected by the queen. This one's hit by the bishop and the queen. This one's hit by just everything. The knight, I'll just finish my thought. The knight, the queen, and the king. This square is protected by both of these. And this is protected by this. So I reckon if we put the rook here, protected by the bishop, we just win the queen. Let's do that. Yeah, so, okay, so we've won a queen for a rook. 9 points for 5 points. Well, how's this going to be anything other than king takes rook? It has to be king takes rook. Yeah, and the thing about that is then my king will be creating a checkmate threat, right? So it's got to be here. And now, can I just ignore this promoting? I want to play here. Because if the rook takes, we go rook here. Oh, hold on a minute. Hold on. That's not quite going to work. It looks clever. Rook takes rook, pawn takes rook. But if I do that and then the king comes across, that's not so clever after all. So I think a better move is actually here. I was looking at winning on the back rank with the check with the king guarding this square, but I think king here is just great because now that rook has to move. And of course, if pawn promotes, we can just take it. So yeah, so king there must be right. Yeah, okay, and we've just won. Do I really have to play another move? Well, it must be there just to win the pawn. Yeah, okay, good. Right, now then. So they're just starting to get a little more tricky. So my feeling here is that there's no checkmate, but I'm spotting the knight and the queen both hitting this square. So let's look. It's always checks, captures, and then threats when you're solving puzzles. So I think queen there forces the king to the back rank. Queen here is check. The only legal move will be to put the queen in the way, and then the knight jumps in, and I think it's checkmate. So let's try that. That's right. And now when we put the knight here, the king can't escape here because of the queen and won't be able to play queen takes because the queen is pinned. So that's cool. Okay, so this is going to be to do really with these white squares, because there's the white's completely dominating the white squares. So I reckon that what have we got in the way of checks and captures? We'll check with the queen here, and I think the king just runs. Check with the queen here, and I think the king still just runs, and we haven't got a lot. But I think this check... Now then, if the king just goes here, queen here would be mate, because the queen and the rook would be protecting each other. And if rook takes, then queen takes. Queen here is forced, queen to the corner. And because she's protected by her mate, it's checkmate. So I think here, all of this is forced. Yeah, and now because the rook is protecting this square, queen here should be checkmate. And from there, the queen guards all of the possible escape squares, look. So there'd be no way to escape the checkmate. So that's quite cool. Okay, so once again, we may have a mating net. The queen is guarding these ones. And we've potentially got the other rook to come into the game as well. So I'm thinking check first. Now, if the rook gets in the way, we just take. So that's going to be winning. And if the king runs this way, we'd go rook here, check. And that's winning because there's no escape. So I think we're going to go rook here. There's one thing I want to look at. Rook here, king to the corner. And then I think queen here forces the rook not to that square, because that would be silly. Yeah, okay. So this is going to be rook takes pawn. Queen here, because now the king's got no escape squares, forces the rook into the way. And now that's checkmate, because the rook is defending where the queen's going to go. All right, so far, so good. This one's going to have to be pawn takes pawn, I think. And then pawn takes king, white gets a move. Let's do that again. Takes, takes, takes. White will move here, but then we'll move king up here, and there's no way for white to defend this pawn, and we'll be allowed to do that. We'll be allowed to be able to do that. So takes, takes, takes. And when I put the king here, my king will be guarding these squares, so this pawn will have to go. And then we just march ours up to get a new queen. There we go. And we just have to keep going. If I put this pawn here now, and the king can somehow get into the corner, it would actually be a draw. So what I have to do is play king here, just to show, so that the white king cannot get round. He can't get anywhere near this pawn. So we'll go here, and that's the end of the puzzle. Okay. Now this has got to be something to do with queen takes pawn, because we've got a battery. But what's the follow-up? I think it's going to be here. The king has to go here. And then after rook here, are we just winning? I think it's going to be there. I can't see anything else. I can't see anything. It's got to be there. Now, is it just rook here? I mean, oh yeah, because I was going to say F2 is a bit weak, but actually it isn't, is it? Because there's the queen protecting it. And no, that's just, I don't know what I'm picking there. The king protecting it as well. So it's going to be here. Uh-huh. And then presumably we just play pawn takes bishop and we want a piece. Yeah, cool. Okay, right. Now what's going on? Okay, now this, everything's going to play a part in this. I'm looking at this bishop here, and I think what we're going to do is we're going to play check. The bishop will take. That will then be allowing us to put the queen here. The only move to block the check from that square will be to put the rook back. And then because the bishop's here, queen takes rook will be mate. So let's try that. Check. And now you can see bishop takes, not bishop takes, that'd be rubbish, but because the bishop is also defending the square, queen takes rook is checkmate. Okay, this one's a classic smothered mate pattern. This comes up all the time. So Notice again the queen and the king on the same diagonal and the knight here. So I need to put the knight somewhere where it's going to be double check, as in the knight will, so when the knight moves, it's already check, but where can I put the knight that will also be giving check? So here looks good because that was check from two different pieces. And now I have, this is a pattern you've just got to know. If I put the queen in the corner, she's defended by the knight. So is it checkmate? Well, not quite, because the rook can take the queen. But watch here. This king now has absolutely no escape squares. He's trapped in the corner, hence why this is called smothered mate. And the knight goes back to here, checkmate. No escape. Okay, right, they're getting harder. This one I don't immediately see. So maybe we've got to the stage where I'm going to have to do some thinking, as well as trying not to forget my sausages, because I don't want to burn the sausages. Right, let's have a quick look. Two pieces, a queen each, a rook each, but black is three pawns up. So whatever we're going to do here, it had better win the game. And I think I've just spotted what it is. So there's no good checks. Well, there is actually a good check here, but let's go through them. So knight here, check. Well, whoopee-doo, rook takes. Queen here, check, but queen takes, pawn takes. No good. Queen here, check is obviously rubbish. But there's one other check, knight here. And the other thing to spot is the queen and the rook are on the same line. And this rook that is flashing now is undefended. So I reckon if we go knight here, check. Oh, well, in fact, yeah, okay. So if the king had moved, we would have had the possibility of queen takes rook. But black has actually played queen takes knight instead. So I assume we just go queen takes queen. It has to be queen takes. We can't play bishop takes queen because the knight would take ours. So queen takes, and that's the end of that one. Right, 27. This can't be anything other than pawn takes rook. There's no checks. There's only the one capture that makes sense. It's just got to be pawn takes rook, but what's next? Okay, right. So, is this something to do with the rook going here, threatening the knight maybe? Because the knight and the pawn and the king are all on the same line. There's no checks. The only captures, that's no good from the knight. Could play knight takes pawn, but it's pointless because we lose that one. I think it's going to be here. So then if rook takes pawn, we'll take the knight and we're reasonably happy with life. Well, we'd just be a straight piece up. So yeah, this has got to be rook here. It's got to be, surely. Yeah, okay. Oh, and that's the answer. Black just wins piece. Well, all right, check, we'll get out of the way, fine. Okay, good. Right, 28. So this is starting to get to the stage where they're a bit more tricky now. This looks weak. The only piece defending this pawn is the king. Currently, I can't play queen takes pawn because the king would take. But what if I put the knight here? So it's attacking that as well. So let's just show you. Put the knight here, and then suddenly there's two pieces attacking that square. And I don't think there's a way for black to defend the situation. Let's put that there. Yeah, now queen takes pawn is check. It will force the king back, and then queen here will be mate. So there, and queen here, because the knight is defending that square, that will be the end. Right, okay. Wow, king stuck in the middle of the board. How do we finish this off? The queen can go there with check because the pawn's defending, which would mean that has to go there. Pawn on check would force the king into the corner. And then knight there, is that mate? King's guarding this one and this one. The pawn's still guarding. Yes, it is. Right, so we're going to do this first, forces the king across. This next forces the king across. And knight takes pawn is actually checkmate because our king is guarding these two squares. The pawn is guarding that one. And the knight attacks the king. 30. I've got to give my sausages another turn in a minute. What's going on about my sausages? I'm starving. Okay, I wonder if this is as simple as the pawn on with check. So it's a fork on the king and the rook. I think it probably is. King takes pawn is not going to be any good because the pawn's defended by my good arrow, by my queen. Yeah, this has got to be here. But what's the follow-up? Is it just pawn here promoting? Because if that's a queen, he has to play rook takes, and then our other queen comes up here. The bishop's defending his checkmate. Yeah, so that's a queen. And then queen takes here is mate. I must just show you. Yeah, because the bishop... Oh, yeah, good. Because the bishop defends that square, queen takes here is checkmate. The queen will be guarding everything that the king could escape to. Okay. So we've hit on a more difficult one, have we? Or is this as simple as knight takes bishop? If knight takes bishop, where can the queen go? She can't go there because our queen's on that square. So that's good. She can't go there because like just a million different pieces are attacking that square. So that's good. She can't really take because bishop takes. So, and if we play knight takes bishop, because yeah, okay, we lose our rook, but we're actually threatening the queen. I think this has got to be knight takes bishop. I think it has to be. Yeah, okay, so the queen's gone there with check, and then we just play queen takes queen, surely. And then we don't want to lose our rook, so the last move of the sequence is just to get the rook out of the way, surely. Okay, cool. 32. Right, this is a good a time as any for a quick pause while I go and turn my cooking over. Right, so I'm back, and I've got my sausages and gravy with lentils. And garlic and sweet corn and peas in with the lentils. Lovely. But, of course, it's too hot for me to eat. So let's do a couple more puzzles until it cools down a bit. Now, checks, captures, and then attacking moves. So queen takes, king takes, and there's nothing else. So that's no good. No, I highlighted that. That's no good. Rook takes, queen takes... Nothing there, but I've got a feeling that the rook being on the same line is going to be something to do with it. And there's no other checks or captures. So I think what we need to do is put this bishop here where it's attacking the queen, but it's also defended by the rook. So the black can't just play queen takes bishop because we take them. Oh, yeah, because rooks move like that, apparently, because we take. And from there and there, that looks quite strong. The only thing is, if we do that, black can just check us. And then we don't seem to be actually winning, as far as I can tell, because he can perhaps just, no, he can't do that because, no. Maybe then queen here and queen here would be good. But he could just block, maybe. I don't know. I need to give this some thought, because what happened when the first time I did this, I got to the mid-30s, and because I didn't want the video to drag on and 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 on, I rushed a couple of the puzzles a bit and made mistakes that I shouldn't really have made. But I'm struggling to see what else this can be other than to cut the queen off from the defence of this square with bishop to here, defended by the rook. I can't see anything else. I mean, there's a cheap tactics. Rook here, rook takes, queen here is going to be mate after the rook comes back. But of course, black doesn't have to take. You can just do whatever. So that's no good. I think it's got to be here because it creates a threat. Let's try it. If it's wrong, it's wrong. Right, it was right. And I was right about queen here. Now, we're not going to put the bishop back because that'll just get taken. So we have to be playing king here. And apparently queen takes bishop is forced. Okay. So I guess that when that was a bishop there, this threat was just too big. I'll take the computer's word for it. I think what the problem is if black had played pawn here after queen here, there's no way to protect this square from the mate. So rook takes bishop, queen takes bishop, and obviously rook takes queen, and we're winning. Okay, good. Oh, okay, I actually know what this is. Now, this is because of the power of this bishop keeping the king trapped. And this rook is going to come into the game. This is really, really nice. So what I'm going to do is give a check that looks ridiculous, looks like knight takes queen, but it actually clears both of these pieces for the rook to come up here. And the only way to defend against the checkmate is rook back, but rook takes rook is winning the game because the bishop defends the square. So let's see that. So queen here, check. The only move is knight take. Well, you could play the rook back, but then queen takes would have been checkmate. So knight back. Now this rook up here is giving check. The only move is to put the rook in the way. And now we take here is checkmate because the bishop's defending the rook. So there's no escape squares for the king. Remember, this one will be guarded by our rook from this square and the bishop guards everything else. So rook takes rook. That's checkmate. I'll just hover it there so you can see it. Okay. Now, I think this is going to be queen here. And my logic is that this rook is then pinned, as in if it moves somewhere, it's not completely pinned, is it? Because if it goes there, it's protecting the queen. So maybe that's not quite right. But we have to recapture the rook one way or the other because we're a rook down. Look, black's got two and we've only got one, so that's no good. Now, there's no checks from queen here, whatever, that's silly. So, and rook takes rook, silly, because rook takes queen. So we're not doing that. So it's got to be either queen or pawn takes. And I think the queen going on the same diagonal has got to be stronger. Pawn takes doesn't look like it does anything. So doesn't look like it does anything. Yeah, that is okay English. Right, it's got to be here. Rook across as predicted, because if the rook goes to say, that rook had gone here, rook takes rook and the queen can't take back because of the pin. Oh yeah, because queens move like that because of the pin. But now the question is, what do I do to finish the game? We know that we've got to be winning because it's a puzzle. I can't check the king like that because queen takes, but I wonder if I can put this here. Rook here. The king will then have to come to one of these two squares and we have another check. But then if the king goes here, isn't he just escaping? Well, I don't see what else it can be, but I don't want to just put in a quick one here and mess up, but I can't see what else it can be but the rook here to start with. Because we like moves that force the opponent to make mistakes. It's got to be here. Then the king's going to come to one of these two squares. And then we can put, I'm so bad at arrows. We can put the queen there. Right, I think this is right. Yeah. And I think we've got to put the queen here also giving check. I just say, if we go queen here, if the queen goes back in the way, rook here just wins the queen because it's pinned. So we know it's not going to be that. It's probably going to be king here. Ah, that's the answer. And then rook here wins the queen. Okay. Yeah. So rook here now and the queen is lost. And if the king had gone here, we'd have had rook here, would have won the queen on this square because it's lost. So we just go there. And that's, let go. There we go. Okay, so we're up to 35, and I want my sausages, but they're too hot. Right. So we've got this battery pointing here. We've got this bishop not only pointing at that pawn, but through it at the queen. That's the king. And this queen is ready to come in at any moment. So this is just a winning attack, but how do we finish the job? Is rook takes going to be crushing? So rook takes here is check. Presumably bishop takes and then the other rook takes. So we'd end up, that'd be gone, and there'd be a rook here. If the king goes to the corner, then queen takes pawn, you're just mating next move. So with a rook there, the king's going to go here. And then queen there? You can't protect this square. And because this bishop's in the way, there's no way for black to get us on the back rank. Right. So I'll show you what I mean. I think that's right. And now I think if I put queen here, there's no way to stop the queen going to here, and it will be checkmate because of the rook. I think that's... Oh, hold on a minute. No, it isn't. No, it isn't. No, it isn't. Wait a minute. Wait a minute. Because queen here, but then queen takes actually defends that square by an x-ray. So maybe that's not quite going to do it. But if it's not, then what is? Well, hang on a minute. So queen here. Queen takes pawn is forced. If I go here, if I go with the rook instead, he has to go to the corner. Okay, right. There's more to this. Now, I don't want to just mess this up. That queen takes pawn move is really annoying. Here we go. I've always got a draw by perpetual checks, which is probably not the answer, but king, rook here, king takes, queen here, check. That'll just be a draw. The king would go back here and we'd be, yeah. It must be more than just a draw here, though. I mean, the last puzzle was 1900 grade, so this one should be around the 2000 mark, which is, we should be getting this. We've got most of it. Queen here, threatening queen there, checkmate. I'm sure that that's the only move to escape. Oh, but hang on a minute. We've just got queen takes pawn and then queen takes the... Yeah, all right, I'm an idiot. Okay, so had he played queen here, we just go queen here and then the king has to go here and then we checkmate in the corner. So that would have been fine. And we can prove that because black has just pointlessly sacrificed his queen. Okay, that I made that look harder than it was. Never mind. Right, that knight is now undefended, which makes me wonder if that's the move, because it's check and then we can check if I can make the arrow reach. But if I play check, queen in the way, and it undefends my own knight. So we'd get that one, but we'd lose that one. So that's no good. What about the check here? Queen takes knight is fine because we're protecting it. So if I have a knight there, I wonder if... right, hold on. So if the king goes here, I can then play rook here. Right, knight here. If the king goes to this square, we play rook here, which is skewering, stroke pinning the queen, and queen takes rook will be no good because the knight defends that square. So knight takes here. And if the king goes here, don't we just win with queen here? King takes knight, rook across. Rook across, rook takes rook check, king takes, queen takes queen. Right, okay, that might look complicated, but I know what we're doing. All right, well, I don't know what we're doing, so I got one wrong. Blast. That's annoying because remember I got 37 on the previous one and now we've lost a life and I don't want to get that wrong. We will go back and see what I missed there because I was sure I was right with knight takes pawn, but apparently not. This one, however, is not straightforward, actually. No, they're getting more tricky now. Okay, so because the bishop is pinning this pawn, it can't take here. So I reckon queen here, if the king goes to the corner, queen takes here is mate because of the support of the bishop. So it will be queen takes. This queen will come back to block, but then we just pick up this bishop and we're just winning, aren't we? We'll just be a piece up. Yeah, okay, so I think here, yeah, that's forced. And a quick look to make sure there's nothing better. Oh, there is something better. There is something better. So queen takes bishop, it looks very pretty. But watch this. Because this queen is pinned, okay, and you can't put your own king in danger, we can play bishop takes pawn check, which forces the king there. Remember, the king couldn't take because queen takes. And the queen couldn't take because queen takes king would have been good. And now we put the knight there and it's checkmate. It's probably something like that that I overlooked in the one that I got wrong. I was probably just being silly. Right, now this, that just looks like a free piece, but it isn't, I don't think, because of the queen and the knight gets out of the way and blah. I think we have to play knight takes knight here. Because after queen takes, we've got a fork on this square of check and here. I think knight takes knight's probably winning here. Okay. It's not a fork though, is it? Because of the bishop. Ah. So I've got the right move, but for totally the wrong reasons. But maybe now we just play here. So I think I've got lucky here because I think I've got the right answer, but for completely the wrong reasons. I think if we play pawn forward, the queen will have to run away and then we just win the bishop. Wow, that's a stroke of luck because I actually got this for completely the wrong reasons. I didn't spot that the bishop guards that square. I was thinking we could just play knight takes pawn, check, win the queen. But actually, that's right. Yeah. And we can't play bishop takes now because the bishop's pinned, but we just play pawn takes and we're a piece up. Okay, right. We've beaten the 37 and I've still got two lives. So let's see what we can do. Now then. I feel like the queen is attacking the rook, but this is defending it. So we've got to do something about distracting the knight. And we've also got this possible move at some point, which I know the knight's attacking it at the minute, but that might be good. In fact, queen takes rook. Hold on a minute. Is queen takes rook not just good? So queen takes rook. If knight takes queen, we put the rook up here. The only way to defend mate is to put the queen back. And then I think we play bishop takes, king takes, rook takes. So I would have two rooks and the opponent would have a rook, a bishop and a knight. And would we be winning? No. So maybe that's not quite right. I don't know, though. I feel like it should be. Have I missed something? I've forgotten we've got another knight down there. So we'd actually be an entire piece up. But in that case, that's right. Yeah, so I was right. I just miscounted the material. So now we don't play rook takes queen. We want to keep this rook so that we're winning on material. We do a distraction tactic. Bishop takes pawn. King has to do that. And now after rook takes queen, we'll have 5, 10, 13 and 6 pawns. So 19. And the opponent would have 5, 8, 11 and 5 pawns, 16. So we'll be winning on material. Cool. Are we at 40? 39. Oh, I thought that was 40. Rats. Okay. Right. This has to be based on this pin. I will actually have my sausages in a minute. I need to stop and think about my stomach for a minute. But let's try and get to 40 first. Yeah, I've just put my hand above the plate. It's warm. Right, is this going to be... I feel like if I replace this knight with this one and then bring the other rook across, that might be quite good. So let's look at this. So rook takes. Now, if he just moves the king out of the way, we just bring the rook back again and we want a piece, woo. So he's going to have to play king takes. He's going to have to play knight takes. I can then bring the other rook across. He'll have to play here. And then is knight there just winning? I think it is because we'd have 1, 2, 3 pieces attacking this square. And if he took here, we'd take there a second time. But that's not actually winning the game, is it? Or is it? Have I just miscounted again, like in the last one? So rook takes, knight takes, rook across, rook has to go here. Knight takes. But if rook takes, then rook takes up there. What's the material? Are we 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 against 6? Hold on, because the king would have to go there. And after rook takes pawn, there's no way to stop the checkmate, is there? Okay, this is going to be right. So I think it's here. I think it's then here. And I think it's here. I'll stop and do the arrows again now so it's less cluttered. So here. So we'd have 3 pieces attacking the knight. I think his only move would be rook takes knight. Rook takes. If he goes that way, we would just play our rook back here and it would be check and we'd win by discovered attack. And if he goes that way, I think we play rook takes pawn and this is just unstoppable. Right, okay, so it's knight takes, rook takes. He's gone that way. So if he'd gone here, we'd have played rook takes pawn and there's no way to stop rook here checkmate without losing this rook to the bishop. So now I guess because this is check when we move this rook, I think we just put it where it does the most damage, which is here, and win the rook and we're material up. Right, we've got 40. Pause because I want to eat my dinner. I'll be back. Okay, so I'm back and I'm no longer starving. So let's see what's going on. So we are playing up the board. We've got the rook potentially hurting the king after pawn takes pawn. This bishop here is guarding, no, it's not guarding that square, that would be cheating. It's guarding those ones. Bishop takes rook's a bit of a red herring because remember we're a queen down here. Black hasn't got a queen. This is the square that's not currently guarded. So I think bishop here check is probably the right first move. So bishop here, the only square the king can go to, he can't go there because of the pawn, he can't take here because of the rook, and he obviously wouldn't be able to go there because of the bishop. He'd have to go here, and then pawn takes pawn looks really good. So I think bishop here, it's not. Oh man, really? Okay. Oh, all right. Well, we'll have a look at the analysis at the end and see what I missed there. I really thought I had that one. Hmm. Right, well, they do get tricky at this point. This one looks like this pawn is just pinned, so it feels like I should just be playing rook takes knight here. But at this stage of the puzzle rush, that's just got to be too simple. Is it just rook takes knight? And the point is, then, if pawn takes, we play rook takes rook check. Is it that obvious? I think it has to be. It's got to be rook takes knight, surely. Right, it is. Okay. Ah, but he hasn't played rook takes back. Okay, well, that's interesting. So he's left a fork on the board. That's clever. So now I've got to think where to put... Yeah, because these are both attacked. That's very, very clever. So maybe I go here with the knight because we're attacking this rook. But then pawn takes, knight takes, pawn takes. I don't think it's very good. Huh. Oh, hang on. What if I go here? Then if pawn takes knight, rook takes rook. If rook takes pawn, we just go rook takes and save the knight. And yeah, that's it, isn't it? There isn't a yeah and really, that's just the answer. It's got to be here. Right, yeah, and now we can save the knight because that's good. We're just a piece up. All right, 41. Hang on, we're playing blacks. So we're going up the board. Shame, so otherwise we'd have like three pass pawns. Right, so the rook is guarding these squares. But pawn check here and then rook across to here isn't going to do it, is it? Because the king escapes. So that's not going to cut it. And we've got no threats of our own past pawns because they're all back here. You know, I could do with the pawn being up on this square or something, but they haven't got one. I feel like I'm missing something. I feel it probably is that with check. Oh, no, don't actually do it. Oh, goodness me. But what's the next move after this? What's the next move going to be? Is it then going to be king here? No, not quite. What about king here? Hang on, that might be the answer. Right, hold on. So pawn here. King here's forced. King here then if king takes pawn, rook across is actually checkmate. Let's just do that again. King here. And if the rook comes across to try and kick my king out of the way, I just go here, and I don't think there's any way to save the threat. Right, so I think it's there, and I think it's there. And I was right, because he's just played that move. I guess we have to put the rook behind the pawn now, because pawn... Oh, yeah, because that's legal. Pawn there won't work, because it's a pin. So remember, we're playing here. And I think if he just checks me, we just do what we did before, and just the rook can't check me again, so we just take it. So it has to be rook here. It has to be. And there it is. And now king here. Well, all right. So now he's just sacrificed his rook and we've won the game. Okay, 42. Right. I've never got this high, I don't think, even on my personal account. So this is kind of cool. Quite pleased. Okay, well, what have we got? We've got a knight check there, but bishop takes knight. And I don't think that's any good. We've got a rook check here, which forces king takes. And then I can go here, and maybe there's something there. Queen will be attacking. If the king goes, king can't go there. King would have to go back to this square. And then if I play queen here, how can he defend that square? Oh, wait, no, that wouldn't be it. It would be queen takes pawn, wouldn't it? Right, so let's just look at this again. So rook, king takes, queen here. King has to go there. Queen takes pawn. The king can't go back to the corner because queen this here would be mate because of the knight. So he'd have to go here. Oh, and then from that square, that's checkmate. Right, okay, so it's here, here, here. And now the knight guards these two squares, so we go here, checkmate. All right, 43. Hi, yeah, 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 yeah. Okay. Something. I like rook takes, queen takes. He's not going to do this, but that would be winning the queen. What's actually going to happen after rook takes, therefore, is bishop takes. I can just play queen takes knight. Oh, we've got too many options here. I don't know what to do. I want the most forcing move. The most forcing move, because it threatens his queen, is rook takes rook. And if he plays queen takes rook instead, that's no good because he's just losing material. Rook takes rook, king takes rook, queen takes. Okay, so I think the checks make no sense, like knight here, queen takes, or knight here, queen takes again. It's just not going to do it. So it's not that. I don't think queen takes knight is forcing enough because he'll just take ours. Right, so it's got to be this first. Okay, and as predicted, now what's next? What's next? Huh. Is it can't just, right, queen takes, pawn takes, we're not winning on material, the material's level, so it's got to be something better than that. Maybe I just do something with the knight. Maybe it's, not the word kamikaze, there's a word in chess for a knight or a piece that gives itself up for material before you take it. A desperado. So if I take here, this is still under attack. So even if he takes mine, then I win that one and I'm a pawn up. Is that it? Or is there something better? We still can't go here because takes. We still can't go here because takes. If I take, he's just going to go queen takes. And if anything, black would be better because the bishop against the knight. The rest of the material is level. I think it's going to be knight takes pawn, you know. I think that's probably the answer, but I'm scared to press it now because I don't want to mess up when I've got such a good score. I think it's got to be. think it's got to be. There's nothing that his knight can take. Look, there's no way he can sort of do a desperado back at me because all these squares are empty. So I think it's here. Oh, what a shame. Okay, well, it was a 2400 puzzle, so it was reasonably difficult. Okay, 43. Let's do some looking to see what were the ones we got wrong. So, oops, wrong button. Hopefully, I can click each one in turn and see what occurred. So 43, that is way my best score ever. I'm really pleased with that. But I bet I'm going to be really annoyed because I bet these three I should have got as well. So let's start on this one. And we need to make the first move. Oh, this is the one where I thought I'd worked it all out and it was knight takes pawn. So let's have another think. Knight takes... Oh, wait a minute. I ruled out queen here because I just figured this would go in the way. But then we do have queen here. Oh, yeah. See, I should have got it. It's queen here. No, it's not. Oh, well, I've got it wrong twice. Brilliant. Right, retry. Oh, man. So, oh. Right, so it's not knight takes pawn. And it's not queen here. And to be perfectly honest, I can't think of any other moves. Oh! Oh, it is to do with knight takes pawn. But not... I think this is rook here, which skewers the queen or pins the queen to the king. And if queen takes rook, then knight there is check and wins the queen. I bet that's it. Yeah. Takes. Oh, man. How annoying. Okay. Yeah, should have got that. Right, quick pause while I find the next one. Okay, here's the next one. Now, I guessed at bishop here, thinking it was cutting the king completely off. But if it's not bishop there, I don't think it can be bishop here checks. The king just escapes. So it has to be pawn takes pawn. There's nothing else it could be, which it is. But now, oh, no, maybe, So the bishop is already cutting off these two squares. So maybe rook here, check. The king has to go there and then pawn takes pawn. And what I've forgotten is the bishop is defending the rook. Right, okay. So it must be here and then here. Oh, man. It's the most frustrating thing in the world when you just think, yeah, if I'd looked at it for a few more seconds, I might have got it. Grrr. Okay, one more to find. Okay, so this is the last one. Now, I was right about rook takes rook, but my guess was that the desperado knight was the way to go. But what else can it be? And queen takes knight just doesn't do anything. He just takes it back, doesn't he? Hold on. I genuinely don't know what this is. But then I said that with the last one and eventually I got there. Well, look, there's no undefended black pieces except this one. So maybe it is queen takes knight. I suppose it doesn't matter now. We can just have a go. But why are we not just losing when he takes us by losing? Why are we not just level, I should say, when he takes us back? What about a move that attacks the enemy queen? What about going here? Oh, God, that's it. Look at this. Knight attacks the queen, so the queen's got to move. Let's say she goes wherever, just put her somewhere. And then this... No, that's not a piece. All right, there, say there. This one then goes here with check. The two knights are protecting each other. The king gets out of the way, and then we take this knight for free. So it's got to be here. Yeah. Oh, wait, but that won't win the knight now. Because when I move this one out the way, the king goes to the corner, but now queen takes won't be any good because queen takes queen. Okay, so there's still a little bit more to this than there looks, isn't there? And once again, can I just play queen takes knight? I doubt it. Oh, well, queen there's no good because knight here would win because of the fork. Queen takes knight, pawn takes. And what am I going to do with him? He's just stuck. So, hold on. Right here. What if I put the rook across here? Now he's got no other way to defend the knight. But if he puts the knight there, then I'm still no good because he'll be def no, that's silly, because he'll be defending the queen. Knight there, pawn takes. That's not gonna do it. I can hardly just put the knight back on this square because that's just silly. And knight there doesn't really help because after the king moves, queen takes, pawn takes. Yeah, it's not gonna do it. Maybe. All right, let's just try it. Is there? And I really want to just hit this knight again with the rook move, but. Knight takes bishop, rook takes, so I don't think that's going to get us anywhere. And if I put the rook across, then I'd have two pieces attacking the knight. But if he just goes back, then I'm not actually getting anywhere because that knight would be defending the queen. I suppose I could then move the queen. Let's just see if it is this. Yeah, oh, it is. But it says that's the end. So what am I missing? Why is the knight there not saving the game for? I'm going to put the analysis board on because I don't quite understand why. So knight takes d3, we knew. We worked out rook takes rook. The computer's doing its thing, look. We know that it's bishop takes. We know that it's here. We know that queen d7's best, and we know it's here. And that's four. So we got to this stage. Rook d1, the computer says, puts us plus five. So rook d1, knight c5 is the best move, which is what I thought. But now I didn't see what was next. Why are we? But I saw all this. I actually saw b4 attacking the knight. But after queen takes queen, rook takes queen. I didn't see why we were winning. This is really a tough puzzle. So here, he's got to do something active. If he just say he moves the queen away, we just play pawn takes knight. So he's going to have to play queen takes queen. Yeah. Rook takes, obviously. Now the knight's got to go somewhere because otherwise I'm going to take it. It can't go there. It can't go there. It can't go there. It could go there. It could go there. It could go there. And actually, the computer's saying, don't bother saving the knight. Well, why? What have I missed that's so. Oh man, this one's blown my mind. Right, let's just put the knight somewhere safe and try to work out why it's rubbish. So, knight a4, what's the problem here? Knight d8. But we're still not winning on material. Oh, well, this is just. A weird puzzle. So it's giving the best move here for black as g6. Oh, okay. So that's why. Oh, okay. Right. The light has just gone on. So this knight is protected by my rook. And from this square, it's cut the rook off from defense of the bishop. So this bishop is unprotected. It's attacked by my knight and it can't go anywhere. If it goes here, knight takes. If it goes here, excuse me, rook takes, so that you actually end up just a piece up. Oh man, that's fiendish. I forgive myself not spotting that one. That's an absolute nightmare of a puzzle. Still, I wasn't a million miles off. I love the name of the guy in this game, by the way, because it just about sums me up. So, white in the game that this puzzle came from, Pelo Ritano, And his opponent, I assume it's pronounced Grumpier, but I love the fact that that says Grumpier, because this puzzle has just made me grumpier. Well, anyway. I think that was pretty good. It's my best ever one. Do I get anywhere near the leaderboard? Probably not, but let's have a look. Puzzle Rush, Survival, Leaderboard. I'm guessing probably not. Yeah, well, I say that's ridiculous, 241. Yeah, forget it. But 54 is, 41's pretty good. I don't complain about not catching up the master players. My personal ones, there we go. That's my best ever one. And daily. Oh, no, I need to look at global daily. Are we on the daily leaderboard? No. So we're not beating the master players. But I reckon 41's pretty good. 43 is pretty good. So I guess the next thing to do is try to set little targets. So when I do another recording of this, we'll have to see if we can get maybe 45 and slowly hedge towards 50. Because two of those three that I got wrong, I probably should have found. But that last one that we looked at, that was ridiculous. That was about 10 moves deep. That was a tough one to find. So, okay, not bad at all. Hope that was quite enjoyable. And we'll do it again another time. Cheers.